Whether you need to set up a survey, collect information for event registrations or an after-school club, or even quiz people that you know, it's never been easier to create forms online. Let's get started by going to forms.new. The first thing we see in Google Forms is this prompt where AI is going to help us create a form. We can either choose one of the templates here, or we can put in a prompt. So I'm going to imagine for this example that I am running a coaching business, and I want people to use the form to book a one-to-one coaching session with me. So I've got this simple prompt. It says, create a form for my clients to book a one-to-one coaching session with me, including asking for information about what they'd like to cover. I'm going to click create. And then Gemini, Google's AI, will get to work and make that form for me. Here's the preview. I can scroll down to have a look at it and check on all the questions if I want to. But to make edits, I need to click Create Form. And here's what the form looks like. So there's a few things we can do here. The first that I might want to do is add a question. For example, I noticed that we're not asking for their company name. So I'm going to click the plus button on the toolbar at the side here to add a new question. Just going to type company name. Like this. And you see it automatically changed this question type to short answer for me. I don't want that to be the first question though. So I'm going to click and drag this down underneath the person's name. And we can also scroll through now and make any edits to these questions that we want to as well. So perhaps, for example, under the specific areas that it's given me in this template, I might remove stress management because I don't cover that in my coaching sessions. Also, I've noticed that none of these questions are required by default, so I'm going to scroll back to the top, click on this first question, and I can click this toggle here to make sure that that question is required, which means people must fill out that question before being able to submit the form. And I'm going to go through and do the same for all the relevant questions on the form as well. Okay, so I've added the questions, I've made the edits that I need to, and made questions required. Now I want to make sure the form looks how I want it to make it match my brand. So I'm going to click on this palette icon at the top, which is where we can customize the theme. That opens this side panel over here. So the first thing I'm going to do is change the fonts. I'm going to change this to Intertight, which is the font I normally use. Choose bold for the header, maybe choose the medium weight for the question text, and then just the normal weight of this font for everything else. And I've got the option to add a header image if I want to. If I click here, there are some that are built in, so I could choose one like this, or I could upload my own with this tab too. I'm actually going to leave that blank for now. And then I can choose a color scheme. Now, I like green, but I don't want a green background, so I'm just going to make the background this light gray color, like so. So it's nice and minimalist. So the form has all the right questions, and it looks the way we want it to. Now let's go and check the settings before we share it by clicking the settings tab. And the first set of settings I can see on here are the response settings. And the first setting in this section is to collect email addresses. Now, I already have a question to collect email addresses, but in here, I could choose verified email addresses, but it does mean that anyone filling out the form would need a Google account. So I'm going to leave that as it is for now. And I could allow people to edit responses if that fits your use case that you're using forms for. And I can even limit people so they can only fill out the form once. That could be good if it's for like an event registration or something like that. But bear in mind, again, they need to log into a Google account for that to work. Further down, we have some presentation options here. For example, I could show a progress bar, which is maybe good if you're doing a long survey. Or if you're a teacher setting quizzes, you might want to shuffle the question order. But one thing you definitely want to edit in the settings here is the confirmation message. So I can click on the edit button here, and this is the message that will appear on screen after people have filled out the form. So I'm going to leave something here which just tells them how long it's going to take me to respond. Then I click save, and that's it. So now we've got everything in the form set up how we want it. It's time to publish it so that people can fill it out. The way that I like to do this is to click the preview icon, which is like an eyeball at the top of the screen here, and that's going to open up this preview version of the form. This is a good way to check that it looks how you want it to. This is exactly what people are going to see when they complete it. And at the top right of the screen here, there's a button that says Manage Publish Settings. So I click on here. That takes me to the sharing screen that you might be used to seeing. And at the moment, it says that the responders are anyone in How-To Tech. That's the company that we're working in. But I want this to be open to absolutely anybody. So I'm going to click on the Manage button here. And at the bottom here, you see it says Responder View. I'm going to click where it currently says How-To Tech and change this to anyone with the link. Click Done. And now I can just click Publish. And I get the link that I can send out to people. Now, I have got a checkbox here to shorten this URL. It's still pretty long though, so you might want to use your own URL shortener for this as well. And once you've sent the form out, you're going to start seeing responses come in the responses tab at the top here. And by default, you see the summary view. And if you want to, you could click the link to sheets button at the top here to connect it to a Google spreadsheet and see everything in there. If I scroll down here, one challenge with this type of form is that I'm going to need to go and find the dates and times manually from the responses and then put them in my Google Calendar. calendar, so there's a lot of admin work involved. One thing you might want to try is using a different tool like Jotform, which will allow you to sync the calendar and have people book appointments directly. So let's take a look. Similar to Google Forms, we start with this screen here. There's a link in the description to get here where I could just choose from a template like a feedback form or a registration form or even a job application. Or I can write a prompt. So I'm going to use exactly the same prompt I used in Google Forms earlier and click send. And Jotform is going to get to work and create that form. Now let's take a look. We can see that it's collecting their full name, their email address, phone number, and it's added this calendar booking widget as well. Now if I go into the settings of this widget, you can see that we can sync this with my Google Calendar, my Outlook Calendar, or Calendly, and I can choose the appointment slot duration and even which available times might show up. So this is going to remove all of that admin headache that I would have had with the Google form. Now let's close this and scroll further down the form here. We've got a question asking what they would like to cover and a checkbox for agreeing to terms. Now, if I want to add questions to a Jot form, I just click on add element on the left-hand side here. You can see all of the different form elements. There's more here than you see in Google Forms. And there's the option for widgets as well. So you can do live calculations as people select things on the form or configurable lists and multiple text fields or even taking a photo as part of the form. But if you don't want to do that manually, you've actually got the form copilot on the right-hand side of the screen. I want to add an option to collect payment so that when people book the slot, they've also paid for it up front. Again, removing another admin headache from later. So I'm going to say add a field for payment, and we can see at the bottom of the form here, it's added a payment field. It's added a product called coaching session for $100. And with this payment field, I can connect it to pretty much any payment gateway that I need to. So if you already have Stripe, or maybe you want to collect payment via PayPal, pretty much anything you can think of is probably on this list. All right, well, I think the form is in a pretty good place. So now we can make it look how we want to, just like we did in Google Forms. So on the top right here, we have the form designer button. Let's click on there. And I can see I can change colors really easily, or even use the AI copilot to ask for a particular design. In the styles tab, you can even put in custom CSS if you want to, or more easily, you can just select an existing theme. I quite like this green nature one, so I'm going to click use theme, and it updates my form automatically. Now, before we publish this form, let's go and make sure the settings are okay. So if I go to the settings tab at the top here, there's a few things I can do in Jotform. For example, I can go to emails and send an auto response email as soon as someone has filled out the form that maybe confirms the day and time of the slot that they booked. There's also the ability to do conditional logic. So for example, I could have an initial question on the form that says, are you a new or existing client? And if they choose new client, they have to fill out the whole form. Whereas if they choose existing client, they just get the booking slot and we ask for their name. And in Jotform, there are lots of different integrations as well. So you could take your client information into Salesforce or into MailChimp so that you can email them again at a later date. So the form looks how I want it. Everything's set up properly. Let's look at how we publish this so that people can fill it out over on the publish tab here. The first thing I could do is just copy this link, similar to Google Forms, and I could send that out to people however I like. Or if I scroll down, there's a really nice QR code option here. If I click on here, I've got the option to download that QR code or even embed it on my website. Though if you're going to embed the QR code, it's probably worth just going to the embed option on the left-hand side of the screen here and embedding the whole form on your site too. Could be in an iframe, but there's also options to make it easier for WordPress and others as well. And once you've sent it out and people are filling it out, there's a couple of ways to look at all of the responses here in Jotform. Let's go up to the top left here where it currently says Form Builder. I'm going to click and then choose Inbox. And the inbox is as you'd expect. It kind of looks like an email inbox, except every new response you get is going to come up as a new message like this. Or if you want something more like a spreadsheet, I can click back up at inbox on the top here and choose tables. And you can see we get this nice table view that looks like a spreadsheet. Each new response will have its own row. And I can also click the download all option to download as a CSV or an Excel file and so on. So you've seen how Google Forms can be helpful for really simple forms. But if you want to make something more advanced, you might want to check out Jotform, where Copilot can do a lot of the work for you. You can add widgets like appointments that will sync with your calendar directly to save you that admin headache, and even collect payments when people complete the form. There's also further options like conditional logic to make some questions appear when they've selected other things, and integrations with products like MailChimp or Salesforce as well. So you can get started using either of them with the links in the description. It's completely free to get started. And if this was helpful, don't forget to drop us a like or subscribe. And if you've got any questions, leave them in the comments. I'll see you in the next one.